In this one, I wanted to show you how you can forward any ports via over SSH, which is really nice when you have like some remote server and you're doing some tests on it. Like, let's say you're testing a new your application, which is HTTP, but you don't want to expose it on the internet, of course, yet. And so you quickly want to access it on your local computer, but as it's running on the server, which is a common use case, but I've used it for a lot of other things as well. But basically what happens is that if you can SSH to the machine, you can literally forward any port on the other machine via SSH to your machine, which is really nice. So to showcase this, I have a little server like this. I don't know, some Debian virtual machine that runs on AWS, nothing special. And I can SSH to it, which is the main part. And let's say I have my HTTP server that is running on there. If I want to, and if this is the IP of this random virtual machine, if I want to try to access it from my computer currently via HTTP, you can see that it just hangs and doesn't work because there is like, even though it's listening on 000, which is all interfaces, there is probably some like random firewall or load balancer or whatever complex things AWS has, and basically I cannot access it. But what you can do is on your local machine, you can SSH and then use the L option for local forwarding. And so this will forward a port that is on the remote machine toward you. And so you first specify the local port. So let's make it 8080. And the remote port we want to forward is 8000. And in the middle, you put just the host. It will the domain name. It will no the host. It will bind to. So you will have to do curl on localhost, and then you can do SSH forward demo like so. And yeah, it's a bit strange. It will create a shell and so on. But if I now curl HTTP localhost 8080. You can see that the request succeeded and we got a request on the remote machine. And yeah, that's pretty nice. And then you can, of course, access it in your browser as you would usually do. Nothing fancy. Well, I guess I can actually show this. Oh, yeah, maybe not with this browser because I have something to show you. But anyway, you can access it in your browser, do anything you would do as if it was running on your own machine. And there is also the same thing if you have something running on your local machine and you want to open a port on the remote machine. So basically the reverse forwarding, I guess. So what you can do is do R, and then this will be the port that is opened on the remote machine. This is the host that will be bound on the remote machine. And this is the port on your local machine that you want to forward. So let's say I run this, and on my machine, I run the little HTTP server now, and on the remote machine, I can HTTP curl localhost and 8080. Yep, same thing, you see, but now I'm on my, it's something that is on my local machine that is forwarded to the remote, which is also quite handy if you want to, I don't know, like, let's say you have you're testing a service out on your local machine and you want something on your server to temporarily use it to see how it works, see how it would work. You can quickly try that over SSH. Awesome. And yeah, that's basically it for the main features of it. But now I will go in details a little bit more. Let's go back to having our HTTP server on the remote. So first, you can see that we are creating a shell like we would usually do, but like generally, you don't want to forward in a shell. Like that's really not necessary most of the time. So what you can do is dash n to disable SSH just running a shell or running any command. So you see now it's forwarded and it's of course still works. Or it should at least. Oh wait, no. Okay, never mind. I still have dash R. So now, see, it still works, but we don't have the ugly shell thing. to optimize a little bit, you can do add dash uppercase T, which will disable the sudo terminal allocation, which is only useful if you're like launching a shell. And you can finally put add F for it to just go in the background. So now it's just some task in the background, but if I try to do my little curl, you can see that it still works. It's just a daemon now. But I'm gonna stop if I can find it. Yes, can I kill you? Yes. Okay. So yeah, those are the mainly the options that you would use when doing this on your test local machine. Something useful is that you can also do it for Unix sockets. So if you, instead of this, let me quickly concatenate all those. Instead of specifying a port on your local machine, you can specify some sock, which will be a socket, like so. I put it in the background again, fuck. Okay, I have to remove this F thing. Anyway, you can still do like Unix sockets and specify the whatever the socket was, and I think it's like still localhost, like so. Right, I have to launch this, like so. And so you can see that now it's over a Unix socket, which is sometimes useful for some applications. And of course, this also works similarly with the dash R option. So you can create a socket file on the remote machine. Next is like by default, if you try to... Well, now I have to kill it. That's so annoying. Is there... Yeah. Did that... I read, grep siege. Can I kill you? Yes, okay, finally. So yeah, by default, if the forwarding, so if you want to script this a little bit, what will happen if you, for example, you bind, let's say 8080, but then there is some kind of error, like for example here I try to allocate it two times, so it says could not request local forwarding. And what will happen is you can see that the command, like, it says a warning, but it's still like it just says a warning, it doesn't exit the thing with a clean error message. So what you can do is add the, there's an option for that called exit on forward failure is equal to yes, and now if there is an error when trying to forward the ports, it will exit with a bad error code. So that's quite handy if you're trying to script it. Also, there is a, like, all this configuration for the forwarding port you can put in your SSH config with the local forward yes, there. So there is a key in your SSH config where you can specify the exact same thing I showed on the command line, but it can be like something like if you always want to map a port whenever you SSH to somewhere, this can be useful. Yeah, besides that, that's almost it, except something that I didn't use before, but I discovered while doing some research for this video, is that you can actually create a socks. I don't know if you even call them like that. A proxy for with SSH. So basically, that's the kind of like the proxy standard that is used by regular application like browser. Or I know that on my phone I have it as well. Like you can connect to a proxy, which I've never used, but maybe who knows? Probably useful for work. Laptop where the whole enterprise has a proxy and stuff like that. Anyway, this option is the D option, like so. So again, those are very similar to before, but instead of dash L or dash 1, you use dash D, which will stands for dynamic port proxy. I don't know. But basically, this can forward like any port. Like any port you ask through the proxy, it will try to proxy them through it. Well, that sentence made no sense, but I'm just going to show you instead of talking. Basically, you specify a host, in this case, localhost, and a port. This one apparently is quite standard, like 1080. And you just connect to your thing. Then in my case, I will go in Firefox, and then you find the proxy settings. And then I went into manual configuration, and then I set the SOX host to localhost and the port I just set. You say OK. And now, whenever you go to a website, you will be all of the traffic will be forwarded, proxied through the server that you connected through via SSH, which is quite neat in my opinion. And you can see that I don't know if you paid attention before, but this IP is the same IP as the remote server. So yeah, that's about it for the SSH. Forwarding of everything. And yeah, hope it will help you debug some stuff on servers or whatever infrastructures like cluster or whatever you use. And yeah, see you in the next one.